Good morning. Today is Thursday. It is the 25th day of Cheshvan. And today we are learning chapter 31 in Igeres HaKodesh. We're about to finish it. The book, this part of the Tanya called Igeres HaKodesh has 32 letters. And we're reading today, learning the 31st letter. And this letter talks about the importance of the unity of Am Yisrael, the unity that we should be united. Why is it so important that we all should be united as one? And he says, he brings in an explanation that in order for us to be healthy, not only us to be healthy, it says in the Zoya, it says that the Shechina, God's presence, so to speak, is ill, is not healthy in the exile. Very strange statement, but he explains it using the analogy of the health in the human body, that when the heart pumps the blood throughout all of the organs, throughout the body, and there is the circulation of the blood and the oxygen that circulates throughout the body. If this circulation works properly, then it's a healthy body. The person is healthy and the heart is healthy. But if, God forbid, there is some clot, something going, the circulation is not going good, even if it's in one organ, it affects the entire body. In order to have a healthy body, in order to have a healthy heart, it's supposed to be a harmony between all of the organs. And they all should work together in helping to circulate the blood throughout the body. And so too, he says, is the energy that comes from Hashem. It comes through the neshamas of the Jewish people into this world. So when we, Am Yisrael, the Jewish people, are connected together, working together with unity, that makes the Shechina, the circulation, so to speak, of the divine presence and the energy working, flowing in a healthy way. So let's see how the Alter Rebbe says it inside chapter 31 in Igeres HaKodesh. Says the Alter Rebbe, Noida v'Shorim, it is no one in the gates, at the gates. What is he talking about, no one at the gates? Yesterday we learned about, we started the letter, Alter Rebbe says that it's no one to everyone. Here it says it's no one in the gates. Gates refers to the gates of the scholars, meaning this is something, what he's saying here is not something which is no one throughout, but is known in the gates to the scholars of the mystical part, because this is something that comes from the Zoya. What is known? He says, Mashakosu besikunim. What it says, a statement in the Tikunim that's part of the Zoya, the Shechinta ihi mara begalusa kaviyachol. That the Shechina, the divine presence, is ailing in exile, as it were. And Alter Rebbe explains, Pirush, to understand, al derech mashal, using an analogy, kemoi choyli aguf, just as in a physical ailment of the body, amavdil ben kodesh v'chulu, of course, distinguishing between the holy Hashem's presence and the physical body. Got to make a distinction. But nevertheless, we can use an example from the physical health to understand this concept. The cause of illness or health lies in the distribution and the flow of the life force from the heart to the organs, amulubeshes bedama nefesh, ayoytze me'alei v'l'kol eivorim. Now this life force, the oxygen, it is being vested in the blood of life, which comes out from the heart to all of the organs. V'soivev, soivev, hoylecha, ruach, chayim, ve'adam. And the spirit of life and the blood circulates all around. It goes all around. Toich, toich, kolay vorim. Into all of the limbs. Al yedei agidim amuvloim bohem. Through the veins that are embedded in them. There are so many veins. I say, how if we would take all of the veins and the sinews that is in the human body, I said there is like 100,000 kilometer of the veins. This is how so complex this whole system, and Hashem created it in such a wonderful way that everything works in sync together in harmony, and they're helping each other, rubbing each other, all the veins to make sure that the circulation of the blood goes through every single part. And then what? V'choizer alalev, and goes back, returns to the heart. Ve'im sibu ve'hilucha ruach ha'chaim aloz hu'kilchosei t'midi kesidroi amasud alo me'achaya ha'chaim b'ruchu. Now, if the circulation and the flow of the spirit of life is always as it should be, in its proper order, as arranged for it by Hashem, the Chaya Chaim, the life of life, it calls it Baruch Hu, Azai Ha'odam Bari Betachlis, then the person is healthy, is a perfectly healthy person. Ki kol ha'evorim mekushorim yachad, because all of the limbs are bound together and receive their appropriate vitality from the heart through this circulation. Ah, but im yesh eize kilkul be'eze mekaymon, should there be any disorder in any place, which hinders or reduces the circulation of the flow of the blood, with the spirit of life vested in it, in the blood, the oxygen, so this bond, which connects amakasha kol evorim el aleiv al yedei siviv alaz, this bond which connects all of the limbs with the heart by way of this circulation is severed, God forbid, or diminished, becomes, then it's a problem. V'azai noifel la'odam la'mishka v'choyli Hashem ishmerenu, in which case an individual falls ill and sick, may God protect us. So the same thing, says the Alter Rebbe, using this analogy, the same thing is the health of the spiritual health. V'kocho mamash al derech marshal, and exactly so, precisely so, metaphorically speaking, in a kol neshama is Yisrael nikroim b'chinas evrish deshchinta. All of the souls of Israel are regarded as the organs of the Shechina. We are the organs of Hashem's presence. And Hashem is referred to anikras b'shem lev. And the Shechina is referred to as the heart. K'may shekasuv, as it says, it is written, tzur levavi, the rock my heart. K'may shekasuv, it is written, v'shachanti b'seicham, and I will dwell within them, pirush, which means ki lashon shchina u'she'or havaya shochen ba'olamos b'riya yetzira asiya la'chayesa. which the term Shekhinah, which means dwelling, is that the light of Hashem dwells in the worlds of Beriyah, Yetzirah, Asiyah, which is the spiritual and the physical world, L'achayosam, to bring them life. V'amshochas chayus zeh, yal yedei islapshus tchila b'neshomes Yisroel. Now this life from Hashem to come to this world, it goes through first through the neshama of a Jew, of the Jewish people. Why? Why does it have to go through the neshama of the Jewish people first? So he says, "Lefi shekol anivroim ein aroich lohem el aboyre izborech." Because none of the created being have any comparable relation to the Creator. The kule kamei kaloi mamish chashivin, because all of the creation are considered naught, as nothing compared to Hashem. Ve'i efshar lahem lekabel chayusay me'oire v'shifo yizborech. And it is impossible for them to receive the life force from the light and effluence from Hashem. To become created being, ex nihilo, something from nothing, and to become, to be living and existing, except by means of the soul. Why? How is the soul capable to bring, to be the one in the intermediary, to bring the life of Hashem to the rest of the world? So he says, she'olu b'machashava, because the soul, the Jewish souls, arose in the thought of Hashem. Ve'kodmu lebriyas oylam eishal yedei b'chinas adibur. And they preceded the creation of the world. The world was created with speech, but the neshama of the Jewish people was created by the thoughts of Hashem, which comes before the speech. Kemaima razal, as our sages say, b'mi nimlach HaKadosh Baruch Hu v'chulu. Our sages say that when Hashem wanted to create the world, who did he consult with, so to speak? With the neshamas. B'nishmeseim shel tzadikim, with the neshamas of the tzadikim, with the Jewish souls. Kanoide v'mokem acher, as it is known in other places. You know, this is why it's interesting when we say the bracha, any bracha, what do we say? We say, Baruch Ata Hashem Elokeinu Melech HaOlam, right? We say, Baruch Ata Hashem Elokeinu Melech HaOlam. What does that mean? Blessed are you, Hashem, Elokeinu, our God. Then we say, Melech HaOlam, the King of the world. Shouldn't we say the other, blessed are you, Hashem, King of the world, our God? Why do we say first our God, then King of the world? Because the way the world receives is through Am Yisrael, through the Jewish people. The neshama of the Jew is the one that enables to bring down the energy from Hashem to the world. That's why it says that if the nations of the world would have known how much the power we get, they get the blessings that they get from the temple in Jerusalem, the holy temple, they would have brought all of the armies to protect the temple, that no one should destroy the temple. Because the blessing that comes to the world is not only to the Jewish people, but for the rest of the world. The whole world receives its blessing through the neshamas of the Am Yisrael. And that's why we say, Baruch Atah Hashem Elokeinu, our God. Then we say, Melech HaOlam, King of the world. That we have Hashem as our God. It enables to bring the blessing to the world. Continues the Alter Rebbe. V'noida b'sha'orim. And it is well known at the gates. כי כל המשוחס, החיוס והשפועס, מעליונים לתחתונים מהם, every downflow of the life force that comes from the upper worlds to worlds which are lower than them, hein kemo shekosu b'sefer yetzira, it is as stated in Sefer Yetzira, the Kabbalah's book, notes tchilason b'sefon v'sefon b'tchilason. The beginning is wedged in their culmination, and the culmination is wedged in the beginning. The beginning, the top is wedged in the bottom, and the bottom is wedged in the top. Bekisvei Arizal, in the writing of Arizal, mechuna b'shem Oir Yosho v'Oir Chozer. It is there referred to as Oir Yosho, direct light, and Oir Chozer, a reflecting light. When you have direct light, it comes direct to the bottom. Then when it hits the bottom, it reflects back. That means that the way the Shechina works is that it pumps the divine energy to us down here. And when we are reacting with doing good things, togetherness, doing the mitzvahs and so on, we reflect back the light to the Shechina. This explains something that Tzemach Tzedek asked, why do we call the Shechina, we just said that the Shechina is like the heart. The Shechina, Hashem's presence, is like the heart that pumps the blood and the energy through all the organs. Why don't we compare the Shechina to the brain? Brain is also something that gives life to all of the organs, that everything receives from the brain. And the Tzemach Tzedek explains, because the brain only works one way. You only see how the brain affects all of the organs. But in the heart, you see that it goes both ways. The blood goes from the heart to the all of the organs, and then it comes back to the heart. That means that when the organs work properly, you have the circulation back to the heart. And therefore, the organs also affect the heart. And the same thing is also, so to speak, that the way we act in this world affects also the heart, the Shechina, so to speak. And that is why the Shechina, as we began this chapter, the Shechina, Hashem's presence, is ailing, is like sick. In Galus, it's not well. We can make it well. We can bring a refuah shleima, God, to the cure, so to speak, to the Shechina itself. Kama shekosu v'achayas rosu v'shuvas is written, and the chayas are the chayot. We're talking about the spiritual energies. Rosu v'shuvas goes back and forth and back and forth. Asher al kain, and therefore al pi. According to these words and this truth, which is impossible to explain properly in writing, this is the nevertheless explains Nikris Ashchina b'shem Lev. The Shechina is referred to as the heart, v'aneshama is b'shem Eivorim, and the souls are referred to as organs. Why? To teach us that all of the souls are attached and bound together. When kasher, when all of the neshamas are bound together, then the circulation and the flow of the life force, that it goes round and around, that it circulates, that's what it's called, it circulates. It's like a circle going around and around. And their culmination is wedged in their beginning. By joining and binding them all together to Avaya Echad, to one God, and to cleave to him, וכמו שכוסוב, אתם ניצבים היום כולכם לפני השם עליכם. As we read in the Parsha Netzavim, it says, you are standing firm this day, all of you, together, before your Lord, the Lord your God. Kulchem daike velefnei daike. It specifically says, kulchem, all of you, and together and in front, elekeichem. Reisheichem chulu mechaita veitzecha, from your heads till the woodchoppers chulu. And this will clarify the teachings of our sages, that the destruction of the second temple and the fall of the Jewish people in down to exile, and the withdrawal of the Shechina, Hashem's presence, and the descent to Edom in a state of exile, as it were. It was because the sin of baseless hatred, that people hated each other for no reason, and a separation of the heart between the people, God forbid. This is why the Shechin is referred to, metaphorically speaking, as ailing. And the reason why it says, we say by Amida, by Shmoyne Esra, we say, Seimech Noiflim V'Roife Choylim. And he supports those who are fallen and heals those who are sick. And it's talking about in plural. Why is it talking plural when we're talking about the Shechina? So it says, because this refers to all of the Evorim, all of the Neshamas. Heim kol Evorim v'cholu. This refers to all of the Neshamas, all of the parts, the organs, that they are considered fallen. And when we get together, and when we stop this falling, the togetherness makes it, the blood and the circulation of the energy flow again together. And this is like the Friedrich Rebbe once said, that when there's a person going on a cruise and he's going on a boat and he rents his room and he goes into his room and then he decides he takes a drill and starts making a hole in the drill, a hole in the boat. So people are coming screaming, "What are you doing? You're gonna take us all down." So what do you mean what I'm doing? I rented this room. This is my room. It's my private place. I'm going to do what I want to do. That's not your business. But of course it is our business, because if you're making a hole in your room, you're going to take all of us down. Whatever a person does affects everybody else. And that is why it is important to be together and to be in harmony with our fellow Jews. Because this is what makes Hashem, like it says, Barchein Avinu Kolonu Ke'echad. So this is the end of chapter 31, end of today's shir. Thank you very much for joining. Please make sure to subscribe and share. And we'll see you tomorrow morning again, 9 o'clock. Any questions?